morning, and welcome to St. Paul African Methodist Episcopal Church, located in Columbia, Tennessee. We're grateful to have another opportunity to be able to come into your homes to share with you, thus says the Lord. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is right, round the young virgin, mother and child, holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. With our follow line in hymn 116. Thank you. Father God, we're just so thankful for yet another opportunity to say thank you. We're grateful, God, to have an opportunity to come into your house of praise, to lift you up, to extol you, to bless your name. Lord, we're so grateful for this season of Advent that teaches us about your first coming, your birth, and prepare us for your second coming. And Lord, you promised us that you will come again. God, we're just so thankful until that day for the many blessings you have bestowed upon us. We thank you, God, for your mercy and your grace. We thank you, God, for your love. We thank you, God, for the many blessings that you continue to bestow upon us. Lord, if we had 10,000 plus tongues, we would not be able to thank you enough. God, you've been so good to us. You've been there for us when we didn't have nobody else. You were there for us when things seemed impossible for us to even bear. You was there for us when the burdens were heavy. You were there for us when the roads were rough to climb. And God, you never left us nor forsaken us. Even in the midst of all that we've gone through, Lord, you just kept right on blessing us. And God, we said thank you, thank you, thank you, from whom all blessings flow. And Lord, we thank you for life, health, and strength. We thank you for our families, loved ones, a church family, acquaintances, associates. And again, Lord, we even thank you for haters. God, we can't thank you enough for all that you've done for us. And I know, Lord, you're not through with us yet. And God, we're saying thank you for what you're going to do in advance. Lord, we love you. Lord, we magnify you. Lord, we lift you up. And we thank you above all for giving us the most precious gift of all, that of your one and only begotten Son, Jesus. And Lord Jesus, we can't thank you enough for leaving your heavenly realm to come to earth, to live among humanity and experience life just as any other person would. And because of what you went through, Lord, you know all about us. Lord Jesus, you were lied on, ostracized. Even your own didn't believe you were who you said you were. But that didn't stop you, Lord, from doing what you came to do. And we're so grateful today that you came to save us of our sins. And right now, God, we pray for forgiveness of our sins by thought, word, or deed. We thank you that as sinners we're saved by your amazing grace. And Lord, we said thank you. We thank you, Lord, that you came with healing in your hands. And God, I believe, just as you healed when you walked the face of the earth, you're still healing. You're still opening up windows of heaven and pouring out blessings and miracles. There are so many names that we could call on this morning. But God, you know. You know who. You know every need. And we're just praying you heal our bodies, save souls, fix hearts, renovate minds. Go throughout the land and minister to every need. And we would be amiss if we didn't thank you for the precious blood that you shed for us on Calvary's cross. The blood through which we are saved by grace. And Lord, we said thank you for your sweet Holy Spirit. Thank you. The Spirit that you sent to dwell within us, to remind us that your presence is always near. The Spirit that empowers us, enlightens us, saves us, convicts and converts. We say thank you. But may God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, all in one. And for those who are in bereavement and continue to grieve the loss of loved ones, we pray comfort and peace. Satan, we know you're somewhere lurking. And in the name of Jesus, we rebuke you. Now, Father, let your will be done. Let your will be done in all things. We pray now in your precious Son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. you've been good to us. And we thank you for this day. Whew. The scripture lesson on this Lord's Day morning is found in the New Testament reading of Luke. Luke, the second chapter, beginning with verse 8. And we're reading from the New King James translation. Luke 2, beginning with verse 8, from the New King James translation, the word reads, "Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you: you will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising the Lord God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.'" The word of God for the people of God. And may God's word fall not upon deaf ears. From all that dwells below the skies. Today is the second Sunday of the Advent season, and we light the candle of peace. The angels proclaimed peace on earth, and the baby Jesus was born. As we think about all of the negative things happening in the land of today, in our nation, we wonder, as we listen to the daily news, is peace possible? With all that's happening throughout the land. We need peace. An inner peace that only God gives through his one and only Son, Jesus. Peace begins with a relationship with God, and it continues as we focus on his strength and allow him to fill us. We can exchange our weakness for his strength in any area of life. God's word says, you will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is loose, is focused on you, because he trusts in you. If peace is eluding you today, if anxiety is spilling over in your life, choose to trust God. You can choose to put your hand in his and draw from his patience and wisdom as you take each step. He will guide you through the maze of life if you ask him. Choosing to trust God with those blind concepts in your life will take you down the road to inner peace. Choosing not to trust him will take you down the road to stress and worry. Inner peace is there for your choosing. Blessed be the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Now, Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. Divine Master, grant us the peace that passes all understanding. We ask in your name, Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. Amen. We thank God for his peace. And if you trust him, he'll give you peace, even in the midst of struggles. Once again, we say good morning to you. We lift up today those who are sick, those who are struggling, those who are without, those who are in need. And sometimes we say, well, Lord, we are the ones in need. But if we look close enough and far enough, we'll always find somebody who's worse off than we are. And we ought to praise God that things are as well with us as they are. We looked up today for the Curtis and Sister Betty Baxter. We continue to pray for them. We lift up Sister Elnora this morning, who's also in the hospital and dealing with this virus. And there are several others throughout the community. There are several others that are sick from other means. There's grief and sorrow all around us during this season of joy. But God, we know you're still able. We know you're still a way maker, a way out, a way anyhow. And that God, with you, all things are possible. And we pray healing and deliverance. Now, a praise team will come to us and lift us up in music. We're grateful for them, our technicians. And let me say to the membership at large, thank you for your dedication and your service throughout these 9 months, 9-10 months. You haven't wavered in your givings and tithes and offerings, the sacrifices that you're making throughout this pandemic. I know it's rough for many, but still, You're doing it. And God's going to bless you. God is blessing you. And God's going to keep on blessing you. And we thank God for each of you. May God bless. Amen.
Over and over again, the Lord let me hear.
Thank you, Brother Richard. Over and over again, he's blessing me. First from Isaiah, the 26th chapter, verses 3 through 4. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever. For in the Lord is everlasting strength. And from Luke 2, verses 13 and 14. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. He'll keep you in perfect peace. He'll keep you in perfect peace. Let us pray. Father God, I thank you, I praise you. Once again, I magnify you. Once again, I lift you up. I praise your name. I thank you, God, for all you've done, all you are doing, all you will do. I thank you, Lord, for this day and this opportunity just to say thank you. Now, Father God, once again, in a preaching hour, I'm praying for preaching power. Lord, speak what you will have your people to hear. Speak what you would have me to say. In your precious Son, Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Silent night, holy night, all is calm. Round young virgin mother and child, holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. He will keep you in perfect peace. And for the people of St. Paul, if you're wondering whether or not you've heard the sermon title before, you have. And no matter how hard I tried, the Lord kept bringing me back to, he will keep you in perfect peace. And although you've heard the sermon title before, the message itself is new. You know, there's always more to say. No matter how many times you quote a scripture, read a scripture, preach a scripture, there's always more to say. Amen. Now this week, I read the news story where Attorney General William Barr dealt the most credible blow to the president's lies about a stolen election when he said the Justice Department had not been able to find any evidence of election fraud. In the past, Mr. Barr came across more as the president's personal lawyer than a neutral arbitrator of justice. No doubt, this will be viewed as a betrayal by a president who demands sworn loyalty from all of his subordinates. This week, I read the story of a Christmas party been hosted by the White House, where most did not wear masks while standing shoulder to shoulder, some audibly coughing. Keep in mind, the White House is already a super spreader of the COVID-19 virus. And speaking of the virus, this week, the story broke where the first vaccine will be shipped to the UK, leaving people in the United States angry because the vaccine has not been approved yet to be used here in the US, when more than 281,000 Americans have already succumbed to the virus. I read the reports this week where the president is attempting to stretch and bend his expansive pardon power. not just to protect himself, but also to shield his three oldest children and son-in-law and his closest associates from future legal problems that had even materialized. Just as the story broke, the Justice Department also said that they were investing a potential presidential pardon scheme where money is allegedly being funneled to the White House in exchange for presidential pardons. I read this week the story of a Birmingham, Alabama, African-American mother, with the help of her own mother, is raising 12 children due to the COVID-19 virus. Francisca McCall and her younger sister, Chantel, had promised to take care of each other's children if anything ever happened to either of them. In September, the younger sister, Chantel, died from the COVID-19 virus. And in October, her husband, Rance, also died from the disease. McCall was already raising 7 children of her own, but without hesitation, took in her sister's 5 orphan children. And they're wondering today how we're going to make ends meet. I spoke with a colleague in ministry who, like other churches in our conference, reviewed church insurance information about how to respond if in an active shooter situation. And although the doors of the church are closed to the public due to the pandemic, like here at St. Paul, he was trying to be proactive and figure out how to respond to anxious parishioners and not get caught up spending all of the ministry time and resources creating safety plans. That's the world we live in today, y'all. This week, I heard the story of a young 21-year-old up-and-coming gospel artist who was sexually assaulted by a relative for several years, beginning around age 5 into his teen years. The young singer said, "While God had his hands on me, my kinfolk had his hands in my pants, my Lord." This week, I'm sure we could add more and more to the list. All around us, there's pain, violence, anger, wars and rumors of wars, aggression, suffering, depression, bigotry, hatred, systemic racism, unequal justice, sickness, and death. Yet, in the midst of it all, we can still sing Silent Night, Holy Night, all is calm, all is bright. Round young virgin, mother and child, holy infant, so tender in my sleep, in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. I wonder how many out there listening slept last night in peace. Today is the second Sunday of Advent. On last Sunday, as we've already stated, we lit the candle of hope. Today we lit the candle of peace. The question is, are we naive for celebrating peace when there's trouble and turmoil all around us? Are we people of faith, followers of Jesus, foolish for talking about peace when the world is facing a global pandemic? Do we mean it when we talk about peace? Is peace only something that happens by and by, at some far off future time, out of control, out of sight, and out of mind? It seems like there's nothing but negative news And yet we're talking about peace. The prophet Isaiah said, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you. After the birth of Jesus into the world was heralded by an angel who proclaimed peace on earth and goodwill towards all of humanity. Some of Jesus' first words after his death on the cross and his resurrection are words of peace to the disciples who had been fearfully hiding away. When Jesus spoke about the Holy Spirit, which is our advocate and strength, Jesus says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I wonder, can somebody stand a little bit of peace this morning? I wonder if anybody need that peace that only Jesus can bring. Now, how do we reconcile Jesus' words of peace with the hateful, anxiety-filled words we hear from the nation's leadership, or should I say lack of leadership? How do we talk about peace when folk are afraid to even walk out of their houses? How can we imagine peace in the world when there's danger all around us? God knew that there would be days like today and that we would need the peace that only he could give. That's one of the reasons that he sent us Jesus during that first Christmas. In Luke 2, we find the story of Jesus' birth in Bethlehem. Joseph, Jesus' earthly father, being obedient to the law, is forced to take a long trip in order to pay his taxes. Joseph's fiance, Mary, who was going to have a baby at any moment, and let me put a little tag here, some folk frown at this passage of the scripture when we talk about Mary being Joseph's fiance, but yet she's with child. Understand, fiance in Jesus' day was not like a fiance today. In Jesus' day, a fiance was the same as a marital contract of the day. Remember that Joseph had plans to divorce Mary. And how could he have plans to divorce Mary if there was not already a covenant between the two of them? But the Lord reminded Joseph that what she's carrying is of the Holy Spirit. And when the couple, after traveling this long distance, Joseph and Mary arrived in Bethlehem. And when they got there, they couldn't find anywhere to stay because there was no place, no room for them in the inn. I wonder how many made room in this biological inn called our hearts, in our souls, for Jesus on this Lord's Day. How many open up your hearts and say, Lord, here I am. All that I am, I'm yours. All that I'm not, I'm still yours. Anybody made room for Jesus? There was no room for Jesus that first Christmas. And understand, folk, when we do God's will, we aren't guaranteed a comfortable life. Amen, somebody. But we are promised that everything, even our discomfort, has meaning in God's plan. And once again, Isaiah said, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is staying on you because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever. For in the Lord, there is everlasting strength. Where there's God, there's peace. Oh, Brother Wayne, the word is saying today that no matter your trials, no matter your ups and downs, he will keep you in perfect peace. If your mind is staying on Jesus, and if you want peace today, Stay focused on Jesus. Although our first picture of Jesus is a baby in a manger, it must not be our last picture. This tiny, helpless baby lived an amazing life, a short life, but an amazing life. Died for us, ascended back into heaven, and one day he's coming back, and on that day he's going to return as King of Kings. And I don't know about you, but I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in, Christ will rule the world and judge all of us according to our decisions that we made about him. Now, if you still picture Jesus as a baby in a manger and not the Lord of your life, I often don't underestimate Jesus. Instead, let him grow up in your life. I declare he will take care of you. He will take you, shake you, dust you off, and make something extremely beautiful out of your life. All you got to do is trust him, and he'll give you peace. In the text, when the angel appeared and announced Jesus' birth, the word said the shepherds were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I bring you great news, good news, a joy that will be for all people today. In the town of David, a Savior is born. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped up in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And the word saying, suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace towards mankind." Don't you know, no matter what you're going through right now, the word is saying he will give you great joy in the midst of your struggles. He will give you joy when people talk about you and scandalize your good name. He will give you joy when folk turn up their nose at you or walk in another direction when they see you coming. He will give you joy. Oh, and when you get just sick and tired of being sick and tired, the Lord will give you joy and have you shouting glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards all of humanity. In the lesson, the greatest event in history had just happened. The Messiah had been born. For ages, people had waited for this. And when it finally occurred, the announcement came to who? To humble shepherds. It didn't go to the kings or the queens or the prince and the princesses, but to lowly, dirty, stinking shepherds out in the field watching their flocks by night. This lets us know that the good news of Jesus, it comes to all of us, including the plain and ordinary. It comes to anyone with a heart humble enough to accept him. Wherever you are, whatever you do, and wherever you go, you can have Jesus in your life. Don't think you need extraordinary qualifications to accept Jesus. Jesus accepts you as you are. It doesn't matter how much dirt we may have under our nails. Jesus will take us, dust us off, and as we said already, make something beautiful out of our lives. He comes to all, including the plain and ordinary. And for those who were told you'll never amount to anything, to those with low self-esteem, he will give you perfect peace if your mind is stayed on him. In a world where there's sickness and death all around us, in a world where there's fear and anger, in a world where people are struggling to meet ends meet, in a world where many can't find peace within, I stand as a witness that through Christ Jesus, peace is still possible. Yes, things around us are going to happen, but is it how we choose to react to stuff that can create or not create peace? Understand, y'all, there can be no peace on earth until we have peace among nations. And we cannot have peace among nations until we have peace within nations. And we can't have peace within nations until we have peace among one another. And we can't have peace among one another until we have peace within our families. And we can't have peace within our families until we have peace within our hearts, the peace that Jesus brings. That's why that little childhood song said, let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Part of cultivating peace in the world is cultivating peace in our hearts. Some try to find peace by tuning others out. Some attempt to find peace by shutting off others from others. Perhaps somebody here today can remember when you were a little child and out of eyesight of your parents. That is, if you were a little black child, if you didn't like something, your parents would say, you cover up your ears or put your fingers in your ears and say to yourself, because if mom and them hear what you're saying, you may be slapped from eternity into peace. But we'll be saying, I can't hear you. Sometimes I think that's our peace strategy, but that's not the way of Jesus. See, Jesus has never covered up his ears or tuned us out. Now that's shouting news. Somebody, he hears our cries and he's pitied every groan. Instead, he never says to us, I can't hear you. Instead, Jesus is tuned in with care while listening to us, hearing our cries, feeling our pains, seeing our struggles, while opening his heart and pouring into us with compassion, love, and peace. He'll give you perfect peace. I know that I got a whole lot more I want to say this morning, but I'm going to just jump to a conclusion. You know, in this life, there are those who at times will face despair and disturbance. And it seems like you are in a continuous combat with domestic difficulties of life. Somebody is troubled by the turmoil of a torn down family. There are those who are blown away by the betrayal of trust by a so-called friend. There are dreams dashed by some unpredicted terminal disease. For others, money is funny and your change is strange. Yes, you work hard to pay the bills, put food on the table, and clothes on your children's back, and they act like they don't even care. But I tell you, in the midst of your struggles, if you just trust in the Lord, Lord. He will give you peace. He will give you a better way. Oh, somebody listening right now may be wondering, where is the peace that Jesus bring? Well, I stand this morning on my way to heaven than to say to you that better days are on their way, that your future is brighter than your past. Oh, can you hear God whisper? Deliverance don't always come, my child, because drama disturbs, suffering strikes, comfort is collapsing. Still, Jesus said, if you trust Him, if you believe in me, if you're willing to let me take control, I'll give you peace of mind. I'll give you a peace that passes all understanding. I stand today as a reminder that the Lord will keep you in perfect peace. Understand, y'all. Will never totally avoid the mess, the strife, the stuff around us. But with God in the midst of struggles, we can know peace. In the midst of turmoils, the Lord is peace. If you want peace, then keep your mind on Jesus. Trust in the Lord. When you trust in the Lord and stayed on Jesus, He'll give you that peace that passes all understanding. And how do you get this perfect peace? Jesus once said, my peace I leave you with, my peace I give you. He was saying the peace, it comes through me. See, I'm going to the cross, and I'm going to purchase your forgiveness. I'm going to satisfy the Father's wrath against all unrighteousness. And I'm going to provide a complete righteousness so that you can rest in me, trust in me, and you will know the peace that I have with my Father. I'm making a way for you. Somebody said a way out of no way. I'm making a way right in the midst of your struggles. I'm pouring into you the peace that exists between my Heavenly Father and me. I'm going to pour it into your life. So right in the midst of all you're going through, I'm going to give you hope. I'm going to give you peace. There will be joy, joy, intoxicating joy. I'm going to give you love. Therefore, don't let your heart be troubled. Don't be afraid. Trust in the Lord. He will keep you in perfect peace. All whose mind is stayed on Him. For remember, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The whole world and things that dwell therein all belongs to Him who made us. He watches us. He lifts us. He brings us. So why should we be bound by stress in this when we are in the hands of Jesus? And as long as we're in Jesus' hands, He will give us peace. He has set us free. That's what He's done. He's lifted our burdens away. He's the keeper of our souls. Therefore, God can once again make a way out of no way. He's peace in confusion, peace in a storm, peace when you can't find your way. He's still again a way maker.
His peace. He's opened doors for you. They can't be shut. He'll be with you not only through the thick and thin, but until the end, He'll keep you in perfect peace. Whose mind is stayed on Him. Trust in Lord forever. The Lord is a rock eternal, a strong tower, a refuge, our strength, our joy in sorrow, our hope for tomorrow. He's peace, peace, perfect peace. Amen, amen, and amen. The Lord will give you peace. All you got to do is trust Him. As the angel in the host said, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards all of humanity. He will give you perfect peace. Wherever you are today, as you stand, God is offering you peace. Wherever you are, God is saying, trust me and I'll take care of you. Trust me, I'll be your Lord, your Savior, your Jesus in the midst of struggles. Just trust me. If you're willing to trust in the Lord, all you got to do is just give your life to Jesus. I can't promise you if you give yourself to Jesus that every day will be a rose garden. It won't be. But with Jesus, you will be all right. Just trust Him. Believe in Him. And He will give you peace. If you need to talk with someone here at the church, call us at 931-388-4069. And now may God's grace, God's mercy, God's peace, and God's love be with us now and forevermore.